And welcome back to Barcelona, Spain. We're about to get a little crazy. I'm Julian Patriot Timecar here with Sam Kirby Hartman Kensler and Richard Pulskamp to yell about this one for all.
Looks like they started off crazy already. I mean, I thought this was going to be the fun mode, but Garen Galio mid lane, that was super exciting.
Yeah, I got to see my Illaoi as well. I'm forever cursed not to see Illaoi in my own games, but it was awesome to watch.
Well, the regional teams are throwing together to create Fire and Ice Super Squad. So first, let's see how Team Fire is lit in the top lane, technically. Although the lanes do not really apply. It is Impact, Bengi there in the jungle, Prey will be AD carry, Levi in the jungle, and Rondo P in support. Of course, the players kind of go wherever they want, but representing their position still.
Yeah, it's a bit all over the place there. Pasty and blustering onto the rift for the Stone Cold Team Ice. It will be Albus coming in here as ADC, Soaz in the top lane, Jankos in the jungle, Klitov also in the jungle, with Ziv as their top laner.
Well, let's have a quick look, of course, for how All For One actually works. It's a bit interesting. I know, Pulse, you have a surprising amount of experience with the mode from last week, but basically each team picks one champ. There's a lottery to determine which champ it is, and then every single person on that team gets the champion. There are no bans. There's only so many champions available as well.
Yeah, as much experience as one can have on this game mode, Pastry, but let's see the champions available for this mode. There's only a couple kind of cheesy picks that we've seen so far, and that's the Zac, because you can actually build tanky. Maybe Kindred could be a bit dirty with the ultimate, but overall, these champions just want a lot of kills to happen.
Yeah, almost all of them are extremely exciting. I did cast it last year as well, the Blitzcrank all, and that was actually 10 Blitzcranks. That just got ridiculously out of hand. I feel like actually in the spirit of the game mode, I need like take a knee or something, get down on your guys' level. There we go. Okay. So the rest of the intro like this.
There we go.
So excited for this one though. What are your guesses so far?
I mean, I know you saw some pretty crazy stuff. Jarvan vs. Yasuo, it felt like a highlight, certainly.
That was probably the most fun one that we had because most of the team fights were all done midair. And it was like, well, whoever lands back down again is the victor of the fight. So hopefully we see some of that because that was super awesome to watch.
I do really enjoy the ones that bring CC because you just multiply by five. The ones without CC, it makes it pretty difficult unless you're Ezreal and you have that extra mobility. But yeah, generally somebody with some knockups or stuns is going to do well.
And we have seen a bit of the Ezreal as well. And I believe Zac is kind of the pick that we don't want to see. That's kind of the strong pick, the cheesy pick of the mode, if you will.
Yeah, there's some a bit of a mini meta that does form in this game mode regarding skins, though. So if you're playing Ezreal, then you will want to pick the same skin because not everyone will go AP. So that random guy who's like 10-0, you don't know which ultimate's going to hit you and which one's going to hurt most. So we'll see what the players actually pick in terms of skins after we've got the champion picks. But remember, this is lottery mode. So if your team doesn't all the green champion, then you might just ram him into something you don't want. But I think everyone knows what they want in this game, Pastry.
I've seen three locked in Lee Sin so far. I see three Harvard Lee Sins on the other side.
I'm actually curious if this is coincidence or if they actually agreed upon it ahead of time to have the 10.
So from my experience, Lee Sin, very, very fun to watch because we were all going in as IWC A-casters being like, ah, Lee Sin, he's not as strong anymore, it won't be as fun. When someone's getting kicked against the wall five times, they literally can't move for 10 seconds, it gets a little bit mental.
Well, Team Fire's getting Lee Sin, that much I can tell you. Team Ice, Albus can still betray the squad and pick something else. It is a lottery, but of course, if every player picks the same champion, which is now what we've got, it's not really random at all.
Everyone's a winner.
All right, let's see about the summoner spells, though, as well. Junglers, I expect to have a pretty heavy hand in this one. I mean, the combat smite definitely helps out a lot. Plus, that's usually going to be the guy getting the most kills because he gets to come, you know, turn the numbers in their favor as well.
It's interesting right now because, of course, we have one smite apiece, which makes sense. Actually, Jankos will be taking jungle for his side, not Klitov. Bengi over on Team Fire. The top laners, and I say that in air quotes, have two of the teleports, but our Team Fire, I guess, thematically, do have three ignites.
So another strategy was to pick a champion like Lee Sin and then be like, all right, guys, who's the best Lee Sin in our team? And then you put your resources into them. So they may put Klitov in a solo lane here to try and soak up those resources and have him as a carry.
It's interesting if, you know, will they designate someone as a tank building Lee Sin as well? Because that could even pose more threat to your team if he gets kicked into your team. It just does extra damage to everyone as well.
And I mean, there's again a lot of chains. Like you said, Kobe, CC can be very fun in this mode just because you multiply it by five. We could see some really intense displacement with a bunch of kicks.
I mean, there's a reason this is the most popular champion in the game. There's a huge potential for outplay. There are those Chi-Chi CC chains that you can get, but he's also a snowbally champion as well.
Well, at least everyone has flash, so we can get some really flashy players. Don't forget, of course, to vote at LOL Esports if you want hashtag Iceman or hashtag Fire to win. But let's be real, at this point, everyone's a winner today. The biggest winner is actually me.
Yeah, I think all of us here casting this game, everyone at home watching, everyone in this arena watching this game, as well as everyone playing the game as well. But we will only have 5 winners coming out of this and some points on the line. But I believe we'll be on the winter map as well for this one.
Ooh, spoilers.
Ooh. Also, more spoilers. The skin wars here, I believe, going to be won by Team Fire, as they do have, you know, the uniform style, whereas Jankos and Ziv actually deviating from the rest of Team Ice.
Well, as you can see, 5 knockout Lee Sins as Team Fire leave the fountain. I believe Ice could not quite agree.
I think this is the better play, honestly, because
I love the ding ding.
Going to hit hard.
Muay Thai and the Boxer one are the 2 best skins. So, you know, deciding between those 2, Acolyte actually, to me, feels like the worst of all of them. Jankos here is going that hipster style, though. Wear it proud.
Well, this is fun because it looks like both teams have actually crept into a brush and they are waiting patiently for their prey. Unfortunately, they're pretty far apart as well, so
all right,
maybe level 1
skill. I'm going to check everyone's level 1 skill. Q, Q, Q for all of Ice. Q, 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 Q for all of Fire except for Levi. He hasn't skilled up yet. The surprise E.
Yeah. Everyone connects their Qs, gets into range. He comes in with the AoE finish.
Find them.
This is a game of battleships right now. I think we're not going to see anyone meet each other just yet. I'm a little worried for Jankos because he's going to stick out like a sore thumb with that skin. So if he
or
gets
will there, he have the spotlight on him when he goes legendary?
We'll have to see. I mean, regardless of really how you do when you have Lee Sin still does a lot of damage, especially when you're also against Lee Sin. So we'll see.
I'm going to be curious to see what the item builds look like. Again, we're going to have relatively standard lane assignments here, and the items do reflect that as well. Of course, the players are not restricted at all in how they can build, so they can go tanky if they want to. And we usually see a lot of Thunderlords. We are going to get 8 here, a Warlord, and a Courage of the Colossus.
That's Soaz with the Warlords there, I believe, if they're lined up correctly. And, yeah, in fact, with Colossus. Maybe he'll be the tank builder of the team.
Oop, Soaz in again. Did have a 1v1 on Lee Sin yesterday in a mirror match, but I couldn't quite hit all the Qs he wanted to.
And that's kind of what we're talking about. If they have Impact build the tanky Lee Sin, that's the team that all have the same skin, so he can kind of hide there. I mean, the bars above his head will probably give it away, but we'll be able to tell by skin.
Oh, then. Let's see if... Oh, in the mid lane. Got that one-on-one trade happening. Prey is going to be close. He's going to jump in. This time, Soaz gets the kill. Redemption for his 1v1.
There you have it. Warlords is OP.
Oh, no. Soaz coming in. Good defense there, but Bengi's actually going to get a Grest on Jankos backing onto it as Soaz going to try and tag him. They need to line up these next Qs. There's a safe guard. Soaz wants it. Not going to get it. Jankos goes for it, though. He's going to get it, but they both die.
Oh, it was an execute. Soaz didn't die to anyone.
He's a genius.
Oh, my goodness.
Welcome to One for All, ladies and gentlemen. This is, what happened.
Let's check back in on the Lee Sin v Lee Sin battle v Lee Sin battle v Lee Sin battle down here. 2 Qs missed by Team Fire.
Oh, disaster for Albus right now. Levi is going to be chased on after by Clearlove. He's got those Lee Sin mechanics naturally from the jungle.
Now, remember, you are going to want to get your auto attacks in. In the early levels, it does matter quite a lot there for Lee Sin when they only have a couple of abilities. They want to run out of energy. But here again, is Banky trying to enter the fray mid lane after first blood was already had?
I like what happens here. Banky detaches in. And so as tags in, does die, but Jankos knows he can get it and still get executed.
As you said, no gold credit there for the opponent. And success, as he was able to clean up the mess.
That's actually really good from Soaz, because if he didn't jump in there and try and make a play, then it would have just been 1 kill over to Fire. So he did salvage that situation with a pretty baller Lee Sin play.
Well, looks like a level up for Prey right now versus Soaz, but he will even that out relatively quickly. Kind of curious to see if that starts to matter, because of course the first Lee Sins to level 6 could be impactful here as well. In the meantime, though, Prey's looking for a roam by the looks of things. Going to make his way down to that bottom lane, but Albus and Clearlove going to try and play this a little safer, perhaps.
I like what the supports are doing as well. Staying true to their support form, going for that Relic Shield so that they can lane with another Lee Sin and get that gold over to them.
Yeah, I'll be curious to see if anyone actually goes with some extra ward items, because you can just use other people's wards, right? And everyone should probably stick with the yellow trinkets in this game, but we'll see if they pick up any Sight Stones or the warding jungle item.
Impact's okay that time though. Did dodge the first Q, which was nice. Now Bengi's actually waiting behind, but he's gonna skip over. He finds Soet now, he's actually looking for the roam in. Q's gonna land in onto Bengi. Damage is decent. That Q's gonna miss though. That one also gonna miss. Yanko's now looking for the next one. They can keep hopping away. Soet's gonna keep moving down. Bengi could be problems, but great Q there from Soet. Does get himself another kill. Oh. Impact gonna look to go down. They're gonna commit for the dive, but Soet's can't fight.
Go on, do it!
Not gonna happen. Okay, I thought maybe one more turret shot was also coming out, but not gonna happen there.
Oh! Tip fake in the big play, safeguards back to Yankos. That's to bail his buddy out on that heist. What a dive.
All right, Ice does have a 1,000 gold lead already, only a little bit over 5 minutes into the game. And this is one of those snowbally modes because, you know, there's no surprise comeback from, you know, any team fight advantage or scaling advantage for either team.
Clearly, there might be in a spot of bother in the meantime, but Ziv and Yanko's actually going to work on this top turret instead. They should be able to get first turret gold here and will. And you can see that gold advantage starting to leverage nicely. So it's been the big recipient of that here at 2-1 and 2. And that early Tiamat, oh, it's going to be good.
Definitely agree there.
Now jump in. I think we're all good, guys, for now. It's worth mentioning that Soaz is massive in terms of Lee Sin's. Currently with that Tiamat, 2-1 and 2, assisted in every kill so far.
Another Tiamat there as well, actually purchased by Ziv, so I think we're probably expecting some relatively similar builds. I'm wondering if Impact's going to go a little tanker with his Courage of the Colossus, but, I mean, that's real. Everyone wants to have fun. The best way to have fun is to kill people on Lee Sin, as Soaz diving in again onto Prey. Ooh, could we get more action here? Trying to make this happen, but no one's sick just yet. Oh, awful lot of safeguards coming out as well, but Bengi gonna tip the scales. Alba's tagged in, that's too cute. Execute damage is all right on top. And our clear love tag, force to fly for the ignite is down, and that's a double kill.
Rano B coming in there for that second kill, and yeah, jungling Lee Sin, Bengi in this one, coming into the bottom lane, getting that quick double kill. I still with a small advantage, but Suat's coming in. They're both gonna kick each other with a DBZ. Fight in the mid lane underneath that tower. Oh!
Oh, Yanko's!
Yanko's out of nowhere.
Wait, there's another challenger, Bengi in the brush.
Looking for something here. He's got his ultimate, I believe, as well, but not gonna commit. He's gonna stalk his prey right behind. Looking through the brush, but he's been caught. Yanko's found him already. Kick back in, another anime moment. They'll fly up.
But look at this dive in the mid lane as well.
Oh, Soaz made it. Okay, what a play here as Ziv dives in for another. Soaz on a killing spree.
Oh.
Soaz, the all-star of the all-star Lee Sin mode here, just going off, being a unique fellow with his warlords as well. It seems to be paying off. Oh no, Albus! By the way, there's only one Lee Sin going a different build than all 9 other Lee Sins, and that is Ron OP being a true support, maxing safeguard second. Everybody else is maxing Q second for the executes.
That will come into a trade later, but currently it's just 1v1s across the map. Praise found Ziv, that's the kick. Will we follow with the Q? Black got the win! Oh, straight up outplay. Prey taking out Ziv there in the jungle.
Beautiful flash right there to the side and lands his Sonic Wave right after.
The Bengi there, you can see again. Going to go out as they just fly away, but help was on the way here.
Yep, Ron OP, here's the support that does come in. And he's able to chase Yankos away, but remember, he didn't max his Q, so he didn't get to kill him. Bengi does finish it off.
I saw Yankos' hands go in the air there because he got the smite off, so he had the extra experience. He thought, the extra health rather, and thought he could get that kill, but taken out just as he threw over that wall.
One of the funny things about Lee Sin, I thought we're going to have something again. So I was playing very aggressive, tags one. Finds a resonating strike onto Prey, but won't follow this time.
So we do have an extra Sight Stone, 2 extra Sight Stones coming in for Ice and 1 for Fire. There will be plenty of wards for plenty of plays.
Yeah, because I don't know where he went there, but he's going to keep getting chased down, can't get over. Levy takes him down this time.
There's so much to keep track of, because when there's one Lee Sin in the game, you're like, all right, Q's going to time out, but who's got the kick? Going to knock both each other back, but Soaz takes the last tower shot. Bengi there with the kill, but Ziv wants some revenge for his ally. But instead, he's going to receive some Lee Sins to take home with him. And Ron going to take him out. But Albus for the support, kicks him against the wall.
Oh,
Prey with the body block, but the bodyguard goes down. Ron OP backing away, but he's in enemy territory, Pastry.
I think it'd be okay, but there's someone chasing him. It is Albus looking to try and take him down here. But up away to the Krogs, looks for the Black Guard, doesn't get him. Is it enough for an execute?
That actually might cost him with the failure on the Black
Flashes in to take him down.
I really feel in this game mode, when everyone's on Lee Sin, then saving your flash is one of the most important things that you can do. It's not worth it just to get away from a kill. You want to make a montage play.
The earlier you use it, the earlier it'll come back up.
That's
here we go, though. Kicks through kicks as both of them get knocked out, but Soaz into the turret does hit a skill shot with his dying breath, though. Maybe baiting them in as he gets then chased down.
Play looking good as well. As you can see, Alba's trying to convert for the tower dive. Jankos once again having a lot of fun here.
Roller coaster of emotions for Jankos. but he is 3-2-4, so mostly positive for him.
Ooh, what's this here? Zip gonna kick one away. Prey now getting chased down by two. Otherly Sims dodges one.
Oh, man!
That's just gross!
Gets ganged up on in the river there. 4 versus 1, gonna go down. Meanwhile, that leaves the bottom lane here to try and push in. The minions, remember the minions, my friend.
Remember objectives always.
I think objectives have kind of gone out of the window at this point, but we're 10 minutes in, we've got 20 kills.
I mean, yeah, Team Ice, they do have the only turret taken. That was the first turret extra bonus there, so that is actually a decent amount of the lead as Ronald Peak goes in to try and get the kick. Ziv out to safety now. They do have numbers for Team Ice.
Oh, clear them again, Rolo P. Goodbye. Oh, mayhem. What's going on? Is this just a bouncing castle? The kicks. Impact, though, safe for now. Alva's trying to look for a cube. Impact gets behind the minions.
Important to keep track of all these wards as well, because any of these things can come out of anywhere. Albus with the kick.
Oh,
out to safety. Prey coming in as well. Albus backing away. He's got the safeguard. Jankos there to block up some of these resonating strikes, but Bengi coming into the bottom lane. Will the L play? Oh, we'll take him out underneath the tower.
I mean, I guess we'll take it. Here is Impact getting low, but Prey gonna protect his countrymen. Tag there for Prey here. Just follow it. That's gonna be a kill. Damage is enough as Jankos now gonna get chased down. Clear up. We're gonna move back in onto Prey. First Q misses there from Jankos. Kick's not gonna miss though. That should be enough. Jankos, I believe, activated TMR to take that down.
Wow, we have learned that there is definitely safety in numbers here. And Team Ice have been grouping up a bit earlier than Team Fire, definitely paying off. But look at that gold. Pretty much back to even after the tower is even. So what's the difference here? It's the objectives. Those are what are swinging it.
I think the hidden hero here from Fire, though, is Levi, who is 3-0-2 right now. He's having a killer of a game. And take a look at his farm. He's completely destroying every other Lee Sin on the map with 107 currently. So Ice need to be careful of that. And he's hidden among the other boxes on Fire. So difficult to find him.
I'm trying to figure out how he found all that time to get farm.
I don't know, to be honest.
I mean, yeah, Team Fire were the ones that weren't grouping up quite as early, so he was left in the bottom lane there, farming away. We'll see if it does pay off. He's a jungler by profession as well.
There's mechanics. Ooh, oh, double punch back. As if an Impact just disengaged from the
area.
So
is the technical term for that the DBZ?
I think so.
Yeah.
Gentleman's trade there. Now Ziv actually outnumbered.
Kick him against the wall. Follow up the standard Lee Sin combo. Bengi making it look easy in the top lane. But that means the enemy Lee Sins are going to jump onto the dragon now. A battle of the century.
Ah, the dragon doesn't stand a chance.
Because they're taken down. Ronald Peak gonna kick one back. There's the kick answering for Soaz, but he's got help. Prey's gonna kick him in towards the turret, but doesn't proc it yet. Soaz gets out to a minion. Levi's gonna find him. He's got friends with it and safeguard him. Levi kicked out, but he safeguards to a friend.
All right, they've got the numbers now, and Team Fire are on the chase.
Bengi, he's on the chase, but maybe he's on the receiving end. He doesn't want to be here anymore. Cleanup goes in, but Albus is the one chasing after. Levi comes out there, but it's Albus who's going to go down, ticking out from the Ignite. Double kill somewhere to someone. 4 kills to 0. Fire definitely came out on top.
Lee Sin with the triple! And Team Fire defend their territory, actually coming back. They've actually gained the gold lead here for the first time as well. See if Ziv can do anything about it.
Winning the first major team by R-Fire. Very nice little play in their own jungle, but Ziv and Prey, both of them make something happen here. Ziv slows him down with the Tempest, kicks him back in. Shooting a lamb, but Prey moves back in. That should be enough, though. Ziv does collect another kill.
Honestly, very impressed you were able to keep up with the skill names there, Pasty. Yeah. But then again, if you just say random Lee Sin skill names, it's probably accurate when you get to more than 4 Lee Sins in a fight. So might try that for next time. Benji doesn't quite land the Q there, but he'll back away. Levi trying to get cheeky there and steal away the blue buff, but Soaz not very happy about this intrusion. 4, 5, and 4. He's a pretty beefy Lee Sin, and he has clear love behind him.
Yeah, good flash there. He's the one with the 6 kills, so a huge bounty on Levi. And that is one extra thing that they can actually start to tell the Team Fire Lee Sins apart from each other because of the extra medallion.
Well, something being set up here by Soaz, perhaps, is in fact Doing a spot of farming for the time being. Actually, does go Titanic card over, he's been tagged by Yankostiff. Here as well, looking for something, but Impact can a safeguard away to a ward. Is there anyone else to try and chase him down? Div up to a ward to try and take him down, and that will be enough.
The Courage of the Colossus, slightly more tanky build. Not really working out so far in the mode for Impact this time around. But Team Ice, let's see what they do with this control of the map.
The Kick Flash, he's got the mechanics, but Bray's going to kick away Ziv. So I'm going in, but so has Albus, Tempest, Allspins, Dragon Rages. Qs are going on. But after all of that, it's Soaz picking up the death.
I mean, which way's in, which way's out anymore? It looks like Team Ice are going to be the ones trying to defend this turret now.
Who's trapped in with who? Indeed. It looks like they're going to group up and try and do something here. Duke in there as if gets kicked back. That's a kill for Ron OP, and they're going to try and defend this turret, but relatively healthy. Everyone's getting tagged by resonating strikes, but the minion waves are getting cleared, and this is something we might have to look at because it is really hard to push down turrets with 10 melee champions.
Definitely true. It's also hard to keep track of which wards were previously placed for plays like that. Levi gets another. That's seven for him.
Levi coming in. Attack up the Titan.
A double!
Coming out here. It's going to be that double kill. Yankos backs away, preventing the triple. But Fire starting to get the upper hand.
King of the Lee Sins right now there for Levi. Eight to his name. He is legendary. Will Team Ice be able to collect that bounty?
We'll have to see because he's certainly been impressive. I'm a young player, no for those mechanical skills. The Stars can look for a free one. Ron OP says no. Double Qs will tag Levi.
Oh.
The first one, but it's the bait onto Yankos. Yankos turns it around and kicks to the face. Going to be a shutdown.
Colossal Titan down.
Answer that question pretty quickly, actually, as Levi. Oh!
Cheese it! Okay,
we're good. No, not good. Never say that in
front of one. Not reading from the same hymn sheet here. He definitely wanted in. Yankos wanted out.
We've entered all mid mode as all the Lee Sins now gravitating towards the action. Impact with the flank as Clearlove goes in.
Next one in for Prey. Ziv's going to follow him, but Ziv actually over the wall by Prey's kick is going to be Clearlove goes down in a 1v3. Ziv tries to make the big play, safeguards him for Albus, who flashes forward and does get Prey taken down. He's low though, it looks to be a kill, and Impact will pick up the next one. Soaz and Ziv, just not enough health.
Well, we're 22 to 18 now, gents. 40 kills on the board at the 17 minute horizon. 3,000 gold advantage to Fire, but is that dragon going over to Ice? So at least we've got that going for us, which is Ice. Ziv Rada coming into the mid lane. Ron, OP, and Impact to find that Q. Got to a fake out style coming in. The Lee Sins are evolving, they are adapting.
All right, let's see if they can make a play here. Lee Sin on the other side of the Raptor pit as well. I don't know about the surprise play from Rankos.
Everyone tag, Levi. Not going to go in for it though, as Clear Level will cover. Ron OP looking for his own flank here, so it's potential turret dives here as they get a little stronger and a little tankier.
Meanwhile, we do have Banky off split pushing, and we talk about objective focus and the Korean focus on that. Still remains true, even in the. Never mind. Looks like it does cost him his life.
Yeah, macro game doesn't quite work out when you're playing 10 Lee Sins, so gets punished there by Europeans who know exactly what's going on when there's no macro going on. Mid lane, Albus. Prey's going to be jumping in there, getting kicked into his allies. But it's now Clearlove who's under attack. He wants to jump away, but there's yet another Dragon's Rage. Ron OP here to support him. He does have his own kick left remaining. That's Clearlove going down. Now Ziv coming in here to join the festivities in the mid lane, but it looks like it's over.
Say that.
Something, but he's going to duck.
It'll never over.
Levi maybe looking to attack the next one. I feel like Clearlove got left out to dry there by his teammates, but didn't really do too much there. Ziv, though, going to dive in, get kicked back through. In between, and there's going to be a kill. Levi kicked back through, though, with Ron OP being moved in towards it. Yanko's going to get exhausted as Alba tries to snipe one on the back end of the fight. Safeguards away to dodge the next Q, though, as now Yanko's looking for another. Ron OP not going to get tagged as Soaz tries to find Prey in. Prey is going to equal in onto Yankos. Yankos is going to kick one back. Levi now going to try and shut it down. I thought we were done. Yankos going to flash away and stop the noise for now, but Bengi could be in trouble.
Ding ding, never done with the noise. Here we go. A couple of misses actually on the Qs.
Round 16, fight Levi coming in there. So as he's off to the side, he's under the Q, but he doesn't really want it. The rest of the Lee Sins are following after. Oh, I've made a terrible mistake, says Soaz, as he will be dropping down. Albus will back away. Q goes awry, and that's yet another kill to Team Fire.
It all comes back to the mid lane. Oh, Banky actually taking a couple tower hits there.
Oh, Albus wants a Q! With a Q, but he gets kicked back by Banky. I like the thought, but it wasn't enough. Prey looks for the kick, but doesn't get a Clearlove. Kicks a bunch of people through as he's looking for the flank, but Prey is going to hunt him down. Clearlove gets that one, but he is going to be answered back by Levi. and it's just everyone trying to take down a tower.
I mean, every once in a while, for a couple seconds, one Lee Sin will go to a side lane to pick up the farm, but has to return mid eventually.
Oh, yeah, and cut. Oh, he doesn't get it, Levi and Bengi there to shut him down. 27 kills to Team Fire now. Rift Herald, oh, never going to be an objective.
No, he doesn't get it.
What even happened there? I couldn't see a thing.
Oh, wait.
The Ignite wasn't quite enough there in the end, but Soaz, yet another fight in the mid lane, chased down by Impact, run OP, tanked up, but Soaz tank Yuri.
We flash too. Not a good sign there for Soaz, and maybe finally we'll take a little extra turret damage. Albus, he's on wave clear duty this time.
All right, let's see if we are able to get any dive action going here. Two reinforcements on the way for Team Fire, only one for Team Ice. There's a little bit of jungling going on for Team Fire as well, trying to take advantage of the extra experience.
All right, I'm not sure which replay this is.
He saw the shutdown, you know, in his sights there, yeah. Wanted to get it off of Levi, but not able to take it down. Return to the objective, though, and so I just cleared out the wave.
And it's done!
With Tower!
Oh, the first tower, like, clear! Oh my god, that feels bad! Right! Huge plays! He bolts into the back line to take him down, and now Impact caught out there, follows in onto Zip with Albus flanking around the backside. Prey and Soaz are tussling, but Soaz should be able to take that down. Last tower shot's on and up, and the Ignite is from Soaz, as they are going to keep chasing. Zip kicks one back through as Levi takes the tower. Kick back into the turret, though. Huge play from Yank on the Europeans. Try to do what they can as Albus skitters away over a wall, but Ron OP still going to keep chasing as Impact really wants his final kill. And Jankos, there's just nowhere to run. He'll get a double for his troubles, but Ron OP should be able to seal this. Jankos needs to keep juking. Ron OP says, I'm just going to order you, but Jankos makes it out of the turret to take
Bengi.
Into Bengi's waiting arms. Oh, no! Huge outplay again!
Oh, Jankos, the king of Europe, making sure he gets that one, and what a play. And that has evened up the scoreboard just a little. The hopes of Ice are resting in the Europeans' hands here, but what an insane display of Lee Sin mechanics.
Yeah, from which one of the 10? If we have 10 Lee Sin, we have to have somebody with a good play. So far though, Team Fire are accumulating a pretty decent lead now. See if they can make use of the extra towers and map control as well. Most of the wards now are on the side of Team Ice, so a bit more plays to be made there.
Man, there's like no chance to take a breather for us or the players in this game. This is absolutely absurd. However, Fire with those two extra tower kills over Ice are edging ahead.
All right, we're going to have to work out a system for taking a breath now.
Looks like we're going to go around the Baron area. And as, of course, the game goes on longer, this should be a bit easier. Baron with his many Santa hats is just chilling out for now. So I was looking to get aggressive, and we're pretty early on into the game still, so death timers won't be too long. I think he's gonna get tagged. Ziv looks for something. Ron OP kicks into the back line. It's Philip kicks one back to it. Bengi, he gets bolted back into another kick. Genius play, as that's a double kick in. Ron OP moved in, and Ice starting to take over this team fight. So it's tagged by Prey. Is gonna go down as Impact gonna try and clean things up, but it's 3v2. Jankos finds it in onto Prey as Albus is getting taken down. Great kick there as well, but Albus just needs to keep the teammates alive. There's another double. Ice coming out ahead as Albus looks for another Q, but isn't going to get it. And Impact, he's fighting with a tanky build. Maybe it's enough, but Impact's just going to juke around, but they will take him now. And there's our ace.
Let's go, Ice.
Jankos, new king of the Rift. He's the highest level Lee Sin in the game. Just wore off with the double buffs, but that is going to be Team Ice's turn to strike back and take down mid turret.
When there's no Lee Sins on the board, it doesn't matter that you're all melee range because there's no one to contest you. They'll be finally able to take away this middle lane tower. And we get to see that one more time. All started off by Albus jumping in there along with Ziv and Soaz.
This is exactly what I would expect a team fight to look like when we have 10 blind players on the map here with all Lee Sins in and out, and then Soaz does get targeted. All right, Jankos.
That's all you're getting,
back
Kobe.
To the objective.
That's the end of the replay.
Don't have enough time, I don't think.
Replay live, what's the difference here? Dragon does go down.
Yeah, another Drake there for Team Ice. So Ocean and Clown added to the tally. A little sad we didn't get the RNG from yesterday, where we just casually put in all the Fire Dragons, but I guess we'll take it this time around. It's better than nothing for Team Ice. You are still behind one tower on objective.
Yeah, we'll take it. Levi is going toe-to-toe with Soaz, but Soaz does decide to back off. He's got many Lee Sins there to back him up, but as does his opponent in the top lane. Baron is still an objective that both teams would like, because the team that gets it, the other team, probably can't clear any of those minions because they're all Lee Sin. Bengi I was thinking about going in there, but we've got the old standoff happening here in the jungle. It's just who wants to go in first. I just remember that Impax, he's running Courage of the Colossus, so he is the initiator for Fire.
Seems to be a correlation between Courage of the Colossus and lowest kills in the game for Impact.
Take
there.
Take one for the team, Kobe.
Definitely working out with the tanking, I guess, because their team is ahead. All right, here we go. The engagement, an insect on someone.
Oh, huge kicks there. Isa kind of scattered around. Ronopi looks for another one, but doesn't get it through. Bengi, they're going to get chased out, and there's another great double kick combo. Ronopi, they're going to get taken, but he gets kicked back into Prey. Who's going to fall as well? No, he lives for now as Jankos flushes out to safety, but he's going to get shut down by Impact. Prey now still trying to chase two, but Ronopi's here as well. Second Q's going to miss, though, and not a bad trade. Two for one in the favor of Fire.
So I was kiting around the top side of that fight as well, but it may not be over. Levi, he is down to half. He's going to jump in, but the Blast changes the course of the fight. Kalilov comes down, but it's the rest of Fire who are in hot pursuit of Team Ice right now. Kalilov, he's trying to get away, but there's no escape from 5 Lee Sin's. Kalilov jumps over the wall, but he's going to burn. He didn't have time to stop, drop, and roll. 5 kills to 1, and that's Fire going for the Baron.
Oh, looks like they're going to get it too. Every member of Team Ice in the fountain. And we do have our first Baron going to go down here. Santa hat and all.
Well, again, there's 10 Lee Sin's, but only two of them have Smite. And unfortunately for Team Ice, their jungle Jankos only just arrived. No time to get back in onto the Baron. And that will be the first Baron. We talked about the pushing and the wave clear being an issue before. This seems like a pretty good solution.
Maybe the only solution. All right, let's take another look at the Blast Cone play here. Take us through it, Pastry. What was step number two as far as the plan goes?
I mean, step one was Blast Cone, step two was Lee Sin Q, and that's kind of all the steps you need in this mode.
Got it. Hit the Q, take the Q. Oh, Albus got hit with a couple there, and that is going to be the end of that play. Thank you very much.
All right, so 38 kills for 30. Pretty standard at 26 minutes. And Jankos, remember that Team Ice have pretty much no wave clear. So as soon as Fire decide to group up, or even just go for a 1-3-1, there's pretty much nothing that the Lee Sin lineup can do against it.
Ah, interesting strategy here from Team Ice. They're splitting up into the 1-3-1. Classic European split. I don't know if you can outpush the Baron up Team Fire, though. We're headed straight down mid.
I feel like I'm using the classic anime glasses push there. It's like, oh yes, I see exactly what they're going for here.
Well, it looks like it's bad times for us. Either way, it's actually really just ripping through the turrets. Here's the flank. Gets kicked back though, Ronopi and Albus looking to tussle, and there's Jankos going down on the other end. 5v4 now, as Ronopi gets kicked back in. Clearly finds a big target on the Prey, but he's going to kick it back into Impact. Not bad, but another counter kick's pretty good. Everyone's trying to get out under the tower. Prey and Bengi are low, but no one's fallen just yet. Jankos, the only death in the team fight.
I mean, I guess it does raise your accuracy. If the other team has all 5 members left up, then it's easier to hit because you miss the one in front of you. There's a bunch more behind him. Looks like Albus, though, no friends around him to escape to.
No, if there's no one around for a split second, we'll be ganged up upon by many angry Lee Sin boxers who will be there to kill you. Mid lane now being pushed in. They have this Baron buff, lots of damage coming down. Turns out you can punch a turret to death.
Oh no, this looks like bad news here. Ziv, yeah, he's got too many people to
he's running
the second Q.
Prey is following after onto Soaz now. He's got the rest of his Lee Sins in pursuit. Double Q, triple Q misses. Soaz, the escape artist, can he make it happen in this
one?
He's been exhausted. He's got one. One versus many. Is he it, man? He's not.
Prey kicked him even though he was dead after that last Q, just to make extra special sure.
All right, now he's got 3 members of Team Fire on his
good
trail.
Good luck, Jankos. Oh no, that's not good, but a decent kick's gonna get a couple. Prey the next target, but Jankos, he just can't get away from this chain. That's Levi with the killers. Albus tries to get one, doesn't quite throw towards Bengi, though. Impact gonna tank that next Q.
Interesting teleport there from Impact. Levi gonna protect him. Necessary to go get those minions, remember? The extra gold there. Look at that. I mean, Levi has not only the most kills of any Lee Sin in this game, but also the most minions. Truly doing work there.
He's been watching a lot of Jackie Chan films growing up, preparing for this one moment where he's going to be in this all-for-one against other martial artists. Now he's bringing it to them, 17-3-12. He's just gone off this game.
Certainly a true master, but Project's up in 40s. About the only good news left for Ice, because Fire have taken over. I can't imagine how difficult it is to kill the super minions in the mid lane. And Baron buff thankfully has dropped off, but we can start to get some additional pressure and see if Fire can try and close out the game. It looks like somebody's in trouble down here.
Or will he make a magical Lee Sin escape? Let's see. Ziv, go!
Who really knows? He's gonna give it a shot. He's gonna jump out. No, he's no.
Pretty short-lived escape there for Ziv as he heads back to the fountain. But I have to say, yeah, it is very difficult to defend turrets as well in this mode. And you have to question, you know, what does a comeback strategy even look like? If you all group up in the same bush, someone's gonna get kicked through and everyone gets knocked up. Is it even worth it?
Well, Jankos. Topsy-turvy fight. Jankos dead already, though. Fire again is hunting together, picking off the Australia Sins, and now Soa's going to try and get his way out. Q's going to miss. Next Q's line up. Impact is going to chase him down. That one's going to hit, but a good kick's not bad. Still the Q will follow as Bengi tries to chase him down. Levi hits the next one. Beautiful accuracy, and just does more than enough damage. Clearlove now in trouble, tries to pop the team out, kicks him away, but it's not nearly enough.
Oh, no. Team Fire, they're just blazing it too hard right now. 4-0, and I think this might be curtains for the Ice lineup. Unfortunately, too many Lee Sins died. They'll head on to the Nexus, and the Nexus Towers, a heroic attempt at a defense from Albus there, but he will ultimately be shut down. Ziv just does not have the technology to deal with this. He almost finds Bray, he finds one. If they go down like warriors, maybe he has a chance, but they're onto the Nexus, and it's Team Fire securing the win.
It just felt like towards the end there, it was getting too difficult. Critical mass was reached. You just keep getting kicked, you're gonna take execute damage. It was a bad time.
I mean, Team Ice actually had a really good start, and I thought that this was gonna be a completely one-sided snowball game, but even with the early kills there and the early turret, Fire were able to make that comeback in the mid-game off of that big Lee Sin play.
Great analysis.
You remember the one I'm talking about, right?
I did that. First Baron certainly looked like some problems as well, but credit where it's due to all 10 players. Fantastic display on Lee Sin. Levi, what a surprising set of mechanics there on Lee Sin, really showing up for Fire. And the two Europeans on the ice side, Soaz and Jankos, looking great.
I don't exactly remember how Levi got all the extra kills or all the extra farm, but the numbers are there to prove it. Yes, he is definitely the best.
He must be the best in this one. And I've generally been impressed by the whole lineup coming in from IWCA. They've had a week's worth of experience playing all these crazy game modes, and they just know how it ticks. They have the upper hand against their opponents. A bunch of them are still in the 1v1s as well.
Yeah, this is not the first time for GPL in Lee Sin's All For One as well, and he had a big showing there last week.
Well, certainly showing off there. Unfortunately for Team Ice, that does mean they are going to lose a couple points, but looks like everyone was having fun there. It was, I feel like slowly but surely the players started to develop a couple things. We saw a few double kick combos here and there, which just means you can't get out from under Lee Sin, because a lot of the early problems were just like, even if you land a Q on someone, you're getting kicked out usually.
Yeah, I mean, we have the normal combos down where you get the kick into the Q, and then someone else kicking him sideways, like, oh no, he kicked him out of the first Q, into two more.
Yeah.
Yeah, generally the strategy was like, get someone low and just kick them to death. If you can land that Q, then you have the execute damage, right? So there was kind of a meta evolving, but like, I think it just got into chaos by the end of it.
The meta is the beatdown meta. Yeah. We'll determine. Actually, more than half of them were punches rather than kicks.
It's true.
Yeah. And apparently that won, so that was the way to go, apparently.
That's true. Now we know what the best skin is. We finally settled the Red Hot debate. I mean, so much fun to watch there as well. I think it's funny to also see people like using flashes or gap close when they're already tagged by a Q, because normally you know to flash, but there's already so many. Definitely a couple problems here.
Whose Q was it?
Exactly.
You know, am I getting out of range or not?
And you never know who's coming for you as well, because they all went for the same skin. So it's just like, is it Levi who's coming out with 18 kills? Maybe it's Bengi who only had 6 kills. I don't know. Maybe a tank's coming after me. But it was just complete chaos from start to finish. We had over 70 kills in 30 minutes.
I mean, we've truly solved the one pro metagame now. Surely after 2 weeks, Pulse.
I got it down pat. Yeah, maybe. I mean, that was our only one of the tournament, unfortunately. I would have loved to see them go for like maybe some of the other picks that we saw, like Jarvan, for example, or Yasuo. But I think Lee Sin versus Lee Sin was the manliest way to go down.
All I know is that whenever it comes back, I'm certainly going to play it. But we are going to send it now over to Dash for a post-game chat with Lee Sin.
I'm going to do my best to make sense of this one, but I've got Levi here with me, as well as Kai, who's going to help with some interpretations here. Last week, you got to play Lee Sin versus Graves in the IWCA All-Stars. Here we are now playing Lee Sin against Lee Sin. My first question to you is to compare these two and how chaotic it was.
Thì coi chúc mừng em ha. Thì câu hỏi đầu tiên là tuần trước mình đánh kèo Lee Sin với Graves. Thì kèo này mình đánh kèo Lee Sin với Lee Sin thì em thấy sự khác biệt nó như thế nào? Thì trả lời nhìn anh kia nha.
Nếu mà kèo Lee Sin và Graves thì 5 con tướng bên này và 5 con tướng bên kia đó sẽ khác nhau, thì em đánh giá con Lee Sin sẽ là cửa trên so với Gray. Còn kèo 10 Lee Sin thì nghĩ là đó là kèo kỹ năng bởi vì 10 con tướng nó giống nhau.
Yeah, so you were saying that last week it was Lee Sin versus Graves. The difference make because of the champions, like anything Lee Sin is stronger than Graves. But this time, it's 10 Lee Sin, so it's all about skills. It's all about skill.
And when you speak about skill, you had the most kills, least deaths, and the most CS in the game. Does that make you the best Lee Sin here at this tournament?
Thì hiện tại bây giờ, cái trận nãy là em có giết nhiều nhất, chết ít nhất, hỗ trợ khá nhiều luôn. Thì em nghĩ em có phải là người chơi Lee Sin giỏi nhất không?
Em nghĩ là không, bởi vì còn khá nhiều game thủ đánh Lee Sin hay và không có mặt trong trận đấu đấy.
Probably not, because there are a lot of others pros that play Lee Sin really well, but not in the match.
All right, well, very humble answer there. Now I want to go ahead and look forward. The 1v1s are coming up next. 4 out of the 5 members of your GPL squad are moving on for Team Fire in this next round. How confident are you and your entire team's abilities about getting Team Fire to the finals?
Thì team Việt Nam của mình sắp tới đánh 1-1 á, là 4 trong số 5 người của mình sẽ lọt vào vòng trong. Thì em nghĩ là em có tự tin với đội chiến thắng của đội Việt Nam hay không để đem lại chiến thắng cho đội lửa?
Em khá tự tin về khả năng vào vòng trong của đội tuyển Việt Nam, tại vì có đến 4 thành viên thi đấu á, nhưng mà cũng chưa biết chắc được điều gì sẽ xảy ra.
So see, he's fairly confident because we have 4 out of 5 guys, so we have higher chance. But you never know until you got in, so yeah.
Absolutely. Just a little follow-up on that. Given the fact that you guys did get to play last week in a lot of these fun modes, you know, the one-for-alls as well as the 1v1s, do you think that gives you somewhat of an advantage having already played some of these game modes previously?
Thì tuần trước mình đánh RUCA á, thì mình đã từng đánh qua tất cả những cái thể loại chơi này rồi á, thì em nghĩ mình có được lợi thế vì mình đã từng đánh rồi hay không?
Em nghĩ là có và được khá nhiều lợi thế đấy.
Lợi thế như thế nào, có thể nói rõ không?
Thế là được làm quen với các chế độ chơi trước nên là sẽ có những cái chiến thuật mà người chơi mới không biết.
Yes, definitely an advantage, and I think that because we have time to dig and have more strategy for the game, so yeah.
All right, well, we look forward to that. I'm going to let you go get prepared for that 1v1. Congratulations again on this victory here. Team Fire now pulling way ahead of Team Ice, sending it back up to the desk to prepare for those 1v1s.
Thank you very much, Dash. Yeah, Team Fire in the end, fantastic performance by then, even though we did see some fantastic moves on both sides, but they seem to be coming up short for Team Ice, guys. What do you think?
I mean, yeah. You got to start in picks and bans. Sorry to cut you off, Cyrene, but I think, you know, both of these teams, they just put it on the rift, your will, my hands, master yourself, master thy enemy. That's what it was about, playing that Lee Sin, making sure that everybody was aware. Team Fire, more committed though, because they locked in all of those Lee Sins much quicker than Team Ice.
Also, they had the skins. They all were wearing the same skin. That's the synergy right from the get-go. Also, star player on that one. They had him on stage. Levi, that guy. Most kills, least deaths, highest CS. At 20 minutes, Team Fire was up 100 CS already.
Zyrene, Levi acted free of doubt.
Absolutely.
Definitely did. What about the Masters we saw? All Thunderlords except for 2-1 Courage of the Colossus as well. I do believe we have a highlight reel of some of those fantastic moves, cues, and all that.
Yeah, you can hear all of the cues coming out. It's quite easy to hear.
Yeah, definitely, especially when you extend your senses. It's something that these quiet steps, the ability to see through things, all of these listens we're doing. I mean, you can just hear and you can just feel exactly all of those sonic waves, all those resonating
tracks. Dragon Rage.
Yes, and there were 290 wards placed. Talk about vision.
Wow.
There was so much on that map.
There is an irony to that, isn't there? 290 wards placed for 10 blind monks.
Yeah. Exactly. One of the host school that saw us yesterday got knocked out on that 1v1 in Lee Sin, so I think maybe he had something to do with the fact that, hey, we're going to pick this and I'm going to make it work. And in the beginning, he had some fantastic moves with Jankos, who is like a standout player on Team Ice, but they didn't manage to translate those early moves into objectives, given it is quite difficult.
Yeah, it's actually quite difficult when they're all melee champions. And I like the build paths of some of the guys. Everybody eventually picked up a Tiamat and was just going crazy, but the Black Cleavers, the early one for Levi, really helped them get ahead.
And the one thing to note as well is that, you know, blindness isn't important against smelly enemies. And that's something that Team Fire found out. They had an advantage from Fairy early on. They really pushed that through, got that Baron. They won multiple team fights, and they closed out the game to get those 50 points.
Yeah, it was super, super impressive in the end. And we were talking about how Team Ice was better at the fun modes, but now they're starting to falter in this one also specifically. What does that mean, Zyrene?
It means a lot.
Yeah.
That means that they're going to have to pick up some more points. And the fact that they have 9 people left in the 1v1s, they're going to have to win some of those 1v1s. We actually had a conversation with Deficio about how they have 4 Chinese players left, and that's going to be big for them. Because
all right, stop. Sonic, wait, whoa, whoa. And listen. Yankos was back, was as bright as Lee Sin. He hit the Q, the kick, and more, but it wasn't enough to settle the score for Ice, baby.
Oh, that was amazing.
I don't know
amazing.
If you're actually laughing, or are you?
No, that was amazing.
That was great.
Absolutely amazing.
How long did you have that?
So, you know, all the times that we were talking about the game in my head, I was just trying to think of this event. But my senses are heightened. Apparently, by not seeing, I get better at rapping, so I think I can live with that. But we got to talk about
Trevor should try that.
We got to talk about... we got to talk about the points. I hope I'm not touching you in any. So, 500 points is that for Team Fire, 350 for Ice. Although, Trevor, you talked about if Ice can win everything, they can do really well. There are some chances. LMS is going up versus a GPL later. The 1v1 is coming up as well, so they're definitely not out of this one yet, but Ice has to do something.
They absolutely do, but luckily for Ice, they do have some very strong matchups in that 1v1. Also, NA, they got a bit smashed around yesterday. LPL's looking good, so that's going to be a tough matchup at the end of the day. And I just think that, you know, Team Fire, they've not earned the All-Star victory yet, but obviously a 150-point buffer is very, very good, very helpful for them. And I think the 1v1s they're going to follow, that's going to be very indicative of whether or not Ice can bounce back.
Yeah, super. Zyrene, how much do you think Ice can bounce back? How much are you confident in your NALCS and Fire All-Stars that they can do it?
I'm confident in the NALCS All-Stars as well as the Chinese and, you know, LCK on top of it. Like, I think everybody's performing really well, and that's why I'm really unsure of who's going to win this 1v1 tournament that's coming up next.
Yeah, it was super exciting, but as you say, we are going to take a quick break, but when we come back, we're going to hit up the Freljord for the round of 16 of our 1v1 tournament. Don't you go anywhere, because we'll see it.
Your will.
No, we won't.
My hands.
Quiero tener su pelo.
My friend, I love this guy.
You English good?
Not good.
Yeah, not good.
Me too.
Oh, he's got Q back up. He got him.
We got him.
Oh my god, I'm boosted.
Oh.
Bo.
Oh. 눈을 안 바꾼 것 같은데?
눈 안 바꿨다. 멀로인데?
특성도 안 바꾼 것 같은데?
에이, 뻥인 거 담.
어?
에이, 연기 너무 티남.
아, 근데 룬특을 안 바꾸긴 했어요.
아, 그것도 이길 수 있겠죠.
어?
파워샷! 다이브!
아, 지지.
You face Mata now next round.
Oh, really?
Yeah, Mata won.
No, you play versus Mata.
No, you play versus
Mata. No!
Might get the queue up again.
Oh, wow! Wow, you're so close! Oh, yes!
Come on, quick shot!
Okay.
Come on,
fine,
quick shot!
Fine! Let's do it.
Let's go!
Not
in my house!
Level two, you're mine!
Yeah, with the ignite and exhaust up as well, it's over.